Hello, everybody. Welcome to this webinar. I'm Carlos. I'm here with Manu.
Hello, this is Manu.
Yeah, we can see that there are the last people still joining to the webinar.
So we are going to wait a few minutes more, wait for the last people to arrive. Carlos, in the meantime, do you mind to make myself the presenter?
Yeah, let me do it.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, by the way, not sure if somebody can confirm that you are able to hear us well and everything looks good, just in case.
Yeah, but for you to know, you have the GoToWebinar chat, okay, where you can actually interact with us. You can ask questions whenever you want, if you have any. And of course, at the end of the webinar, we are going to spend some minutes to hear your questions. And we basically want you to participate in the webinar. Okay. So if something is not clear or if you want to cover some scenarios, we are here to help and to cover them as well. Okay.
Okay. So just wait a few seconds. The last people is joining. It's already.
Yeah, we have a few more coming. I can see it. Perfect, Carlos. I think we can start.
Okay. Yeah, we can start. Well, as I said, we are Carlos and Manu, and we'll be presenting today this webinar. What we are going to present you is a new plastic SEM feature that it's called Incoming Change. Okay, so well, first of all, let's start reviewing the agenda for today for the webinar. Just as a brief introduction, the Incoming Changes view is a way to preview, download, and solve merge conflicts when you are working behind the head of your working branch. Okay. Typically, teams that where the developers work on the same branch is something very popular for instance, in the game industry. And with this new Incoming Changes view, we greatly improve the workflow, removing unneeded merge operations. Okay, we will see it in detail during the demonstration. But for now, maybe Manu, we can show very fast how it looks, this new feature, this new Incoming Changes view. Just to commend you, this feature is available for both the Plastic SEM GUI and the Gluon user interface. On the left side, Manu is showing how it looks in Gluon. If you click on the update button, you will see that the Incoming Changes view shows a preview panel with all the new file revisions pending to be updated in your workspace. Okay, the good thing is in Gluon, you can manually select the files you actually want to download. So as you can see, it's very flexible. If you are familiar already with the Gluon workflow, you probably already know that you can select the files you want to download during the update operation and ignore the files you don't actually need. Okay. We will go in detail with this topic during the demonstration. If we take a look into the Plastic GUI very fast, there is also in the top right of the GUI, there is a resolve button. If we click on it, it's pretty similar to what we've seen in Gluon, but the difference is that in Plastic GUI, when you are updating, when you're clicking on resolve all the conflicts, you actually are downloading all the files in your workspace. Okay, this is, I mean, if you are already familiar with the difference between Gluon and Plastic, probably you know that in Plastic, when you are running an update, you are actually updating all the content to the last of the branch. Okay, as I said, this is just a brief introduction to show you how it looks, but we will be reviewing in detail during the demonstration. Okay, this is just an initial approach. Just to give you some more background about this feature, we developed it to together with some video game companies, and the result is based on their feedback, okay? The most common user type are developers or artists working on a single branch with binary files and using logs, okay? The incoming changes view also allows you to resolve all the potential merge conflicts when you are updating your workspace. I'm not only talking about file conflicts, but also directory conflicts. For instance, if a coworker removes a directory in the branch where you are working, and you are at the same time have performed locally some changes in this folder, Plastic will be proposing you two alternatives to resolve this conflict. It allows you to keep your changes or keep the folder removed, okay? If you are familiar with how Plastic is handling the merge conflicts, both for files or for folders, you will probably know that we are very good handling this kind of conflicts, and this power of this merge resolution is included also in the incoming changes view, okay? Another very interesting feature about this new view is that it allows you to keep a linear history in your branch, okay? As we commented, this feature was specially developed for teams that are working everybody in the same branch. And if you are following this kind of workflow, you should have seen that tons of merge links and sub-branches are appearing in the branch explorer diagram, okay? This is how it used to work. And this is actually what we have changed and what we have improved with this new incoming changes feature. During this demonstration today, we will always see a very clear linear history in the Plastic branch where you are working. Even while we will be updating the workspace and resolving multiple conflicts, the same clear linear history will be happening, okay? You won't see any sub-branches or merge links that is making more difficult to understand what is happening. And well, we will see it in detail during this demonstration. This is just like summarizing all the new features and things you will be enjoying when using this new incoming changes view. Well, I think just it was okay just as an introduction, but I think we can directly go to the demonstration time. During this demonstration today, we are going to show you three scenarios, okay? The first one is a scenario where this new incoming changes view is still not enabled. So this way you can compare how it used to work versus how it works with the new view. This old way of work is what we call update merge operation, okay? You probably have heard it in the past. After this first demonstration where the incoming changes is not still enabled, the second demonstration we will show you how the same scenario is handled when the incoming changes view is enabled. You will see the differences and how it's much better now. And then just to finish the demonstration, we will show you a similar scenario but handle it in Gluon, okay? Just for you, so you. As we have commented, this feature is available both in Plastic V and Gluon. So we want to show you both scenarios, okay? So I think Manu, you can continue right now the demonstration.
Okay, perfect. So yes, what you are seeing right now in my screen is the branch explorer of Plastic SCM repository. And I'm actually trying to fake a developer or an artist working behind the head of the branch. As you can see, my house icon is drawn in this changeset, representing that I'm not switched to the latest of this branch. And as Carlos said, I'm going to first show to you how it used to be without the incoming changes view, something that we call the update merge operation. It was the first initiative to go to this direction. So being on this change set, I'm going to change something in my workspace. I have a Unity project here. I'm going to check out a file or directly modify it, double clicking. Let me go and add a new using system.io, a very small change in the beginning of the file. Okay, perfect. So now what happened if I go to the pending changes view? Well, Plastic is telling me that I have incoming changes. I mean, something is in my branch that I don't have it yet. Okay, let's click in view new changes. And as you can see, I have several items here. Some of them are needed to download. Let me show it to you. This remarks column, because it explains that those files I have down here are added on source. Some of them are, they have changes, but only in source contributor. And at the end of the day, I have a conflict here because it seems that another coworker has changed this file at the head of the branch. Okay, perfect. Let's go and resolve the conflict. Okay, it was completely automatic. That's good. But what happens when I go to the pending changes view? Here is where the trouble begins, okay? As you can see, I have a mix of changes that are mine and some others are not. If you remember, I changed this file. You can see the differences that I added to system IO, but at the same time, I have a lot of files that I have no idea where are they coming from. So as a developer, maybe I can understand what's going on underneath, but as an artist, I'm completely sure this is annoying. Actually, this is the feedback we have had for the last months. That's why we were very interested in improving this workflow and came up with this idea of the incoming changes view. Okay, as you can see, I have a pre-populated pending changes view. Let me go type a comment. This is after my change. The thing is that I'm not sure if I should add this content or not because it's not mine. Let's check in. And now when I go to the branch explorer, I see something like this, which is also disturbing. I have a new change that created and something down here that is what we call a sub-branch. It represents that I've been working behind the head and some of my local changes were in conflict with the head of the branch. And we used to represent this as you are seeing, okay? That's something we have changed. We have fixed this. Now we keep a linear history and also we have fixed the pending changes view mesh. Okay, so right now I'm going to switch to another Plastic SCM interface with the incoming changes view enabled. It's this one. As you can see, I also have a change. Let me show it to you. Let me go to the to the pending changes view and show the differences. It's actually the same change. Okay, I'm replicating exactly the same scenario in this different repository. So Plastic, as you can see up here in the notification bar, is telling me that there are 8 new changes available, okay? And it's red because it's detecting that there's going to be conflicts that I need to resolve. Otherwise, it would be a green notification instead. Okay, so let's continue. Let's click resolve and let's see how it looks like. As you can see, it's pretty similar to what we have seen. Okay, there's a slight, small difference here, and it's the remarks column. It says now that only one file requires a merge. It will be, as you saw before, it will be an automatic conflict. Some of the files are changed. That's what the C stands for. And the remarks column says that the files are going to be updated. And then we have new files that basically is more or less the same thing that will apply the add to my workspace. Okay, so it looks more friendly. And now when I resolve the conflicts, this is what happens. I have my pending changes view completely clean. I only have my change, my real change. So now I'm updated, my workspace is now working with the head of the branch, and I have my pending change available to be submitted to the repository. I have my change, only that, and now I can see that there's no trouble, there's no difficulty here. is just my change, is the change I've been working for in the last minutes. Okay, so added a new using. I can give a good comment. I only have one change. I'm not messing with a lot of changes anymore. And when I check in this change to the repository, the branch explorer looks like this, a linear history in my timeline. Okay, I don't have sub branches anymore. So it's much easier to understand what's going on right now. Okay, this is how it looks like. So we believe this much better solution than what we had before, much easier to understand by developers. Nothing to say about artists. They love it, how it works. Now, actually, I'm going to show you how it works in Gluon, because we support incoming changes also in Gluon. And well, this is how it looks like in the regular plastic SCNW. Okay, of course, in my scenario, I didn't have a manual conflict. If you saw that there was a conflict in the file, but it was a completely automatic merge, no troubles there. But we of course support directory conflicts, as Carlos said, manual conflicts for files. Do you know that Plastic SCM supports semantic merge? It has semantic merge capabilities, so even regular merge conflicts that are manual for test-based tools, merge tools, for Plastic is not that hard, because we are semantic for several programming languages. Okay, so let me move to Gluon right now. Let me remove this. And in Gluon, well, it's more or less the same thing. I want to show you how it looks like when you don't have conflicts with the head of the branch. You have these new changes available notification here, up here. And instead of resolve, I have an update, because my local changes are not in conflict with the head of the branch. But as I need the changes made at the head of the branch, I want to click update. And it gives me a summary of the changes that my coworkers have been performing. Okay, as it's a Gluon workspace, I have the ability of selecting what I want to download and what I want to prevent to download to my workspace. Well, let's do that. As you can see, there's a new file that it's an AVI file that I don't want to get it right now, because it's 1.5 gigs. I don't want that. Okay, it's very big for my work. Is right now it's not mandatory to get it, so let's remove it. I don't want to get it, and I just want to get the first three files in my workspace. Okay, I can do that. I click update workspace. I only get those, and I can continue working. Okay, of course I still have more content available, and so if I finally need that file, I can get it, update the workspace, okay, get a nice progress bar, and it's done. Okay, now I have it in my workspace, I can continue working, and this is how it works. You can full control of what to get in your local working copy and what to keep in the repository. I think it's very nice for artists to have this kind of feature. So, well, that's the end of the demo. Just to highlight the changes with it, the incoming changes view allows you to resolve the conflicts and get the latest contents of your working branch. And at the same time, we keep a linear history to prevent weird branch explorers. Okay, the branch will be a single line with no sub branches. Much more easier to understand for newcomers, for new user, or not that technical users. And the second point is we keep you a clean pending changes view without changes that you don't understand where they are coming from. Okay, so that was all. As you can see, it's all the Plastic SCM features very easy to use, but at the same time, very powerful. So we hope you enjoy the feature. We want you to try it, and of course to provide us feedback. So now, Carlos, if you want, we can jump into the questions time. Yeah. If you, as I said before, you have the GoToMeeting, sorry, the GoTo webinar chat where you can raise your questions.
And
we will be more than easy. So if you want to read them, I think we have at least one.
Yvonne is raising the hand. Let me check why I'm not able to. Okay. Yvonne Gomez is asking, when will this feature be available? This is already available in Plastic if you upgrade to the last version. Is enabled by default after the version 3.9.7.5. Okay, it's remember that Plastic is in 8.0, and the specific number for the version will be enabled by default. This feature is 3.9.7.5. Okay, so if you just upgrade to the last, you can already use it. Okay.
Perfect.
There is another question. From Michael. Hello, it looks promising. Does it look like a Git rebase, right?
That's a good question. It's actually really similar to a Git rebase. The only difference is, as you may know, Plastic can behave in two different ways. It can behave in a centralized way and distributed way. For the game industry, what we have seen is that all the game studios, they were centralized. This incoming changes view is supported in the two ways. On the other hand, Git only supported in distributed is the only way they can work. Okay, so with the Git rebase, you are the only one working on the repository. You do the rebase and then you push the changes back to the central hub. Okay, with Plastic it's not that way. We support it in a centralized way, so we are more than able to handle cases where dozens of developers are working at the same time at the same branch without any trouble. So more or less it's the same concept, but one system distributed only and the other one centralized and distributed.
Okay. Not sure if you have any other questions.
No, I cannot see more questions. Let's see. Let's give a few seconds more to check if you have questions. Otherwise, I think we can stop. There's another one. What was the decision behind enable this feature by default? Well, the motivation behind is that we believe that if you are working at the same branch, it's much more easier to have this feature enabled than the other option, don't have this feature enabled. If you don't have it, you will end up in the first situation with a lot of merge operation happening, with a lot of changes in your workspace, and it's a little bit more obscure.
Yeah, I mean, there is no reason to don't enable really by default, because all there are only advantages. We don't see any specific problem for enabling. Even it's still possible to disable it via configuration file, but not sure if it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, actually, as Carlos said at the beginning of the demo, we have been in contact with at least two studios. One is like 50 to 60 developers. The other one is 150. And both of them were demanding a better workflow for the single branch development. They had a lot of troubles with the sub branches, and they are currently working with the incoming changes much better than before. So we think, we believe it's a big win for them.
Yeah, I think Christopher is also asking if they work from a single branch. Well, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, Manu,
yes,
you can continue. Yeah,
they work on a single branch. Both of them, they use Unity. They are Unity developers, and they have troubles with the Unity Merge tool. Okay, so at the end of the day, it's really hard for them to work with multiple branches with a Unity project. So yes, they end up working at the same branch and using the exclusive checkout feature we have to reduce the merge operation. So it's all about flexibility, and Plastic SEM allows the workflow, and we saw that they are much happier now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that maybe in this game studios there are still some people creating branches and then running merges of these branches, but most of the people are working with binary files like Unity assets and stuff like that. And for this specific kind of role in the company, is what will they enjoy more, this kind of work, okay? Because they need to work on the same branch, they need to lock their binaries, their assets, and when updating their workspace to the last of the branch, this is perfect for them.
Of course, we still recommend to work in branches. I mean, working in branches with Plastic SEM is super great. And we have also customers in the game industry as well that they are using pretty well branches, also with Unity projects. At the end of the day, it's all about how you structure your Unity project. For example, for some users, they have scenes inside scenes to avoid the merge operation to the upper level scene. So that's a way to try to avoid the merge operation. So, we have a great variety of users. Of course, customers outside of the game industry, they regular developers, I mean, with source code, they don't have this kind of problem, okay? They work nicely with branches, and I think they will not use the incoming changes. But for those teams working at the same branch, which is actually very popular from our experience in the game industry, I think it's a big win for them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, not more questions for now.
Okay. Of course, we are available for you. Christopher is saying that it's a surprise for him to know that large teams would work from a single branch. It was also shocking for us. That's why we implemented this feature, because it was a huge problem for them. So for us, of course, you can unleash more power from Plastic if you work based on branches. Okay, we have been recommending for years the branch per task methodology, but sometimes that is not possible. And hopefully, in the future, it will be. So let's see. Right now, for the teams working at the same branch, this will be a better solution, a better workflow. But at least that's the feedback we have been receiving lately with this feature. Not sure if you're very welcome, Christopher. If you have any further questions about this feature, this incoming view feature, or any other Plastic SEM workflow feature, we will be more than available for you at the support email, support@codedsoftware.com. And we will be, as I said, available for you.
We are also recording this webinar, so you can get it or share it with some members of your team or wherever you prefer to review it. Just let us know and we can send you a link.
Okay. So thank you for all the people at the hall. As I said, I can see a lot of people, but only a couple of questions, I think three. I'm sure you have more. As I said, if you have more questions, we will be there for you. So thank you very much for attending. We will keep in touch.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.